beautiful spirits. Welcome to the channel. My name is Donna, and I'm so glad you visited today. I'm so happy to see you here. We have a thoughts, feelings, intentions, and actions reading about your love interest or person that you came to ask about or wonder. So we see Feast of Plenty, choices and their consequences. So that is the thought process your person has right now. They're thinking a lot about the empty well, the fact that they haven't seen you enough, that they want to replenish, they want to rebuild the relationship. It looks like there's been some discord here and there's some things that need work. They feel very much that they need to have clarity with you and sort of organize the relationship so that both of you are on the same page. So in the recent past, the energy that your person had in terms of what they thought about you is they think you're the one, the Ace of Coins. They want to make an offer. They feel as though you have been disappointed in them. They feel as though you have not chosen them. Your person feels very sad, very lonely without you, but again, they feel as though you did not accept an offer that they made. When they think of you as a soulmate energy, someone with whom they would give their all. They do carry a heavy burden around with them because they miss you. They are very obsessed with you, Virgo. We have the Capricorn energy, Cancer. We have Sagittarius. We have Scorpio, and we have Aquarius energy here. You are dealing with somebody who thinks that you're an absolute rock star. They can't imagine wanting anybody else. Again, in their thoughts, they feel as though you're the one. In terms of their intentions, we see that Ace of Coins repeat itself. Your person wants very much the Heart of Wands energy. They have fire in their belly to win you back, to make you come back into a relationship with them. They feel as though there has been some sort of ending. The Ten of Swords tells us a story that they may feel as though you've betrayed them. They may feel as though they have betrayed you. But what we're seeing is someone who really isn't accepting your offer. That when you think of them, you feel defeated. You feel like it's over. You feel as though they didn't take your offer of the Ace of Pentacles, which you gave up here. You gave up the burden. So we have two new beginnings. Ten of Wands, Ten of Swords. Ten of Swords is Gemini energy. So you've been all up in your head. Your person has. When we look at their intent, they're in their heart space, they absolutely adore you. They see you as this fiery queen. They want that new beginning. They want to invest with you. But you know, personally, I like to see different cards here. This is heart space energy, but I don't see them sort of in their heart space enough. They're very practically oriented. They just know they want you. They know they're obsessed in having you. When we look at their intentions for you, Virgo, we see someone who truly loves you. They want to offer a cup of love to you. They intend on doing that. If you don't accept it in the near future, they will walk away. We see them in this energy of feeling they just can't take any more defeat. They just feel as though they somehow have not measured up to your expectations. The Sun card says that they find you to be their happy place, their joyfulness. They want a reconciliation with you. So if there was a betrayal here, this person looks as though they want to make amends to you. They want to win you back. They want for this burdensome energy to be over so that you accept their offer of love. The Two of Swords, the Nine of Swords says that I don't think you're speaking right now. So in their intentions, they don't know quite what to do with it. They know that they have to really take time to replenish. They have to think about the things that they can tell you that will give clarity to the relationship. But right now they seem to be very wary, very fearful, you know, staying awake at night, losing sleep. They want this reunion. You are their joy, their happiness, their romantic interest. In terms of their actions, they will make a choice. They will make a commitment to you. They don't know if you will accept the commitment. The Hermit card says that they're searching for answers. It looks as though for many of you, they put you in some sort of competitive situation. If this is a new relationship, they didn't take themselves off of a dating site. If it's an older relationship, they may have been flirting or keeping contact with some old friends, because we get the Four of Swords energy. So in their action, they see you as absolutely the person. You're the Empress. You know, they need to heal this energy. They need to heal the toxicity of this Devil card, somebody who tries to control you while they do whatever they want. But the Five of Cups and the Five of Cups, look at that. This person is holding these two cups of love so that they don't get spilled. The reading starts with the Five of Cups. It ends with the Five of Cups. So it does look like for some of you, Virgo, you may never really be able to get over this. This may really be a final energy for you. So let's take a little sidebar trip over here and look and pull some cards on how you're feeling about this person, because truly it does not look like you're very sold as the reading begins and ends with the Five of Cups. So Virgo, tell us how you feel about this person. We're going to pull six cards. We're going to do a mini Celtic. And so Virgo, what do we have? You have fire in your belly. You're happy. You're content. You're feeling good about your life. The Six of Swords, you're moving away from anything that looks like trouble. You know, that Six of Swords is very powerful energy. It speaks to the fact that you have healed yourself. What else do we have? You made a head over heart decision, Virgo. You know, we look at that energy, that's the Libra Queen. You judge this person fairly. You gave them every chance that they should have. And now you're moving away. You're taking care of yourself. And it doesn't really look like they're a part of things. The King of Swords energy with the Queen of Swords energy says that you tried to tell your person what you thought, what you needed, what you wanted. But it doesn't seem that they really were able to deal with it. They look like they were very much in the, I have to move that, the Page of Pentacles energy. This person may be younger. They may be dealing with another family life. But the Page of Pentacles is somebody who's just learning. So it looks, Virgo, like you feel as though the person you were dealing with is, you know, they're smart, but you feel as though they have a lot to learn. The Five of Wands, you're going to continue dating other people. The Five of Wands energy is all simply about you not being willing to give them your undivided attention because of what they did with you. You know, the stabbing in the back, the controlling behavior. So right now, Virgo, what I am seeing, and let me know if this is accurate, you know, in the comments below. I answer all the comments, but I want to send you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. Tell me your love story. I do answer all the comments, and I absolutely adore that you have visited me here, and I thank you so much. Take care, Virgo. Bye-bye.